Hello friends and welcome to my channel M-Square Analysis Project. Today we are going to see shape functions of a triangular element. So please subscribe to my channel. So this is one triangular element that is having node 1, 2, 3 which is numbered in anti-clockwise direction. There is a point P inside this triangular element. So for this point or anywhere in this within the element, we will get a three shape functions, which is denoted by n1, n2 and n3. So to find out the shape functions, we have three different methods, that is Cartesian coordinates method, natural coordinates method, and one more important, that is area coordinate method. So this is one of the simplest method, area coordinate method. So we will see. So let's get to area coordinate method. Now this is a triangular element having the coordinates for this each node. One node x1, y1, second node x2, y2, third node is x3, y3, and there is one point which is denoted by the coordinate x and y. This is in the Cartesian coordinate. Now what we will do, see this is important here. So let this is a point P. We will join this point with the node 1 by using this straight line. Then we will join this node 2 with this point P, and then we will join point P with the node 3. So we will get three areas here. So in front of node 1, we will get the area A1. In front of node 2, we will get the area A2. And in front of node 3, this is the area is denoted by A3. Now we can find out the area by using this formula. So this is the area formula 1/2, and it is a determinant of matrix. So in first column it will be 1, and in second column it will be the coordinates x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. So for example, if we want to find out total area of this triangle is A, then we can find out using this formula. Here it is 1, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. If we find out the determinant, divided by 2, we will get the area of this triangle. Similarly, we are having these three triangles here. So this is a area A1, this is area A2 and A3. So we can find out these values of areas using this method. Now this is finding out the shape function. Shape function is defined by A1 divided by A. Means for node 1, we will get the area A1 divided by A. Here area, total area of the triangle is always bigger than this A1. So we will get the fraction value. The maximum value of this N1 will be the 1. Similarly for N2, you can get it A2 divided by A. Similarly for N3, you will get the A3 divided by A. So these are the three shape functions for this triangular element. 1, 2 and 3 nodes, three shape functions are there. Now we will see the variation of these shape functions. So for this is a triangular element, so we can get any point somewhere here, or on the edges. So we can get anywhere in this triangular element and on the edges. So at that point we have to find out the shape function. Let's suppose the point P lies on this edge, which is in between 1 and 2. So we join this point with the node 2, and if we join this with 1 and 2, so there will be no area in this region. So in front of 2, there will be no area. So A2 will be 0. So A2 is 0, then you will get the same function, N2 will be the 0. Means if there is a point lies between this line anywhere, you will get N2 will be the 0. If the point lies somewhere here, then N1 will be the 0. If point lies on this line, then N3 will be the 0. Now let's assume some point somewhere here. So we can find out the shape function at this point, and as the point varies, the shape function values will vary. The maximum value of the shape function, now for this node 1, so maximum value of the shape function N1 will be 1 at its node. So this is the maximum value 1. Its unity magnitude is unity. So according to that, it will be going on varying. So this is the triangle basic and shape function. We have lifted by this unity, and if you see linearly, we have joined this. So values of shape function n1 will decrease from 1 to 0.5 somewhere here, 0.25, and on this edge it will be 0, as we have seen there. Now for example, n2 shape function. This is the second node. So maximum value of the shape function will be here. So we are having maximum value. This is 1. So this is node 3. This is a node 2. So we will join these two lines like this. Okay. So the maximum value of shape function n2 will be here. And as if we see in the middle, it will be 0.5. At the edge, it will be the 0. But at node 2, other shape functions n1 and n3 will be the 0. That is the rule or property of the shape function. For the node 3, this is the third node. So maximum value of the shape function is 1. And here if you see, it is going to decrease. Means this is a triangle we have lifted here with the unit. So we get shape function variation like this. So this is a linear variation because it is a simplex triangular element, so that it's called as a linear variation of this shape functions. Thank you. Subscribe for more finite element videos.